Jenny Sabin, welcome to the University of Huddersfield.
Thank you so much. It's a pleasure to be here. It's my first time visiting this area, so it's a real pleasure.
I listened to your talk with interest. I just wondered, how much does the environment play in all the experimental work that you do in architecture? How important do you feel it is personally?
Oh, it's fundamental. The environment is a major design driver in all that we do. For example, my early research and work in collaboration with Dr. Peter Lloyd-Jones, we started Lab Studio together, was primarily looking at the promise of how context and environment influences and specifies form. And that came out of his expertise as a matrix biologist, where half the secret to life in that scenario resides outside of the cell. And so for me, that presented a series of very powerful ecological models as a way of thinking, not mimicking biological form, but drawing from the processes as a way of thinking through a design process where environment is fundamental in terms of its integration with a design scenario and the production of form. And over the years, I've also been influenced by thinking through a material system that begins to specify particular environments or inspire other environments. So drawing upon functional aspects that relate to sustainability, thinking about how we can also incorporate important issues such as beauty and the promise of a personalized architecture. And so that scenario of integration, of feedback, of iteration, of incorporating environment and its various contexts at all scales within the design process is absolutely fundamental.
Do you think we have a lot to learn from nature in terms of design?
Absolutely. I think nature gives us, some incredible models for thinking. In some cases, scalability makes sense. In others, it doesn't. I think in my case, certainly some of the projects share a formal expression that might conjure particular natural systems and models. But I've never been interested in just scaling up what might be a beautiful form found in nature, but really thinking what's behind the image, what has informed the production of that natural system. And so in the context of all of the crises that we face, climate change, issues of sustainability, that's certainly not my area of expertise, but we end up touching those issues through a way of thinking that draws from nature as a teacher, that then begin to develop quite functional and specific materials that are responsive and adaptive.
The University of Huddersfield, inspiring tomorrow's professionals.